Hi, this is Camille. I'm here with Gavin, and today we're going to be demonstrating how to set up a working Pi system in a virtual environment. This is a diagram which shows some of the key features of a typical Pi system. You have a data source, which is going to send information to the interface, which will then go to the Pi server. Now, a user would be able to use an application such as Pi Process Book to trend information from the data source. And then also relational context is provided by the Pi AF server.
As stated before, the end goal of this video is to get a working Pi system in a virtual environment. And the way we will achieve this is by making three separate virtual machines on a host machine. As you can see from the diagram, we have three virtual machines. The first virtual machine is the Pi server machine. VM1 is going to have SQL Express, the Pi AF server, and the Pi server. VM2 will be our interface node, and on this VM we will have the OPC server, we will also have the Pi OPC interface, and the Pi ICU. And lastly, we'll have on our third VM the client applications, and this will include Pi SMT, Pi AF Client, and Pi Process Book.
Okay, so now that we have an idea of what we're trying to create in this YouTube video, let's look at the pieces that we're going to need to achieve this. This is a list of the installation files that are needed, and so it's probably easiest at the very beginning of this video to go and acquire all these files, so that's not something that you'll need to do throughout the process. In this video, we used VirtualBox for our virtual machine software. Also, for our data source, we used a simulator, and for the sake of this video, we used the Matricon OPC simulation server, which can be downloaded free from their website. One final note, we are using the Windows Server 2008 R2 for all of our virtual machines, and so we will need to have the operating system disk image to be able to set this up. Okay, let's get started. First thing we'll need to do is we'll need to download and install the VirtualBox. We already have created a folder which has all the installation files that we will need for this video. So we're going to run. We'll be running this as the administrator. This is a good practice in general. So we can select next, 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 and yes. This will finish the installation. Okay, so now we've successfully installed VirtualBox. So we're going to begin our setup of the virtual machines. This can be done by selecting new. And the first thing that we're going to be asked is to type in the name of our VM. So the first VM we're going to create is our Pi server. So we're going to call this VM1 Pi server. Also, we'll need to select the type and version. So in this case, we're using the Windows 2008 64-bit. We now need to select the amount of memory or RAM for our virtual machine. Gavin, how would you go about making this decision?
In our situation, we need to keep in mind that the VM is sharing the resources with your host machine. 512 megabytes should be enough.
Okay. So now we're going to create the virtual hard drive now. And for our hard drive file type, we're going to keep it on the default, the VirtualBox disk image. We're also going to change the storage on the physical hard drive to fixed size. So this may take longer to create, but it is often faster to use. And we're going to keep the virtual hard drive at the default 25 gigabytes.
Now we have the first VM set up. First thing we want to do with this new VM is go into the settings. And what we want to pay attention to in here is the network option. In this screen, we're choosing what the network adapter in our VM is going to be. In our situation, we want to choose the Bridget adapter. This will allow the VM to come into the network through the host machine with a unique IP address. You might notice in this field below that we have two options for which adapter of the host machine that we are connecting through. And the one that you want to choose is the wired adapter from your host machine. And an easy way to identify this is to go to Control Panel, then Network and Sharing Center, And if you go to Change Adapter Settings, you can see all the adapters on your host machine. In our situation, we see that local area connection is coming in through the Intel 82579LM. So we want to make sure that that matches what's in the box right here. So we recognize that it does. The other setting we want to change is we can go to Shared Folders, and VirtualBox provides this nice feature which allows us to share folders between our host machine and the virtual machine. So for this video, we want to share this YouTube video folder, which includes all of the installation files which we'll need on the VM. Once that's added, there's some configuration that needs to be done within the VM to get to access the shared folder, which we will do later. Now we're ready to start the VM. So when the VM starts, it prompts for the location of the disk image. As mentioned before, we are using Windows Server 2008 R2. So we open the disk image. Okay, now we're at the Windows installation screen. Most of these settings we can keep as default. So here at this screen, you have several options of what kind of version of 2008 R2 you want to install. And in our situation, we're just going to stick with the R2 standard full installation. You want to go to Custom, and this will allow you to choose the hard drive where it's installed, and you let Windows install. Okay, so now that Windows has finished installing, we're going to set up the administrator account. Alright, once we are at this, at the desktop, we can begin the initial configuration of the server machine, which Camille will show you how to do.
So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to activate Windows. And so in this case, you're going to need the product key. So make sure that you type that in, and then you'll be able to finish the activation process. Okay, so now that we've successfully activated Windows, we're going to look into changing the computer name and the domain. So select Change. In this case, we're going to rename our computer to this virtual machine to VM1 Pi Server. So this will be helpful for us when we're pointing to the different connections between our virtual machines. And the next step we're going to do is we're going to join the domain. So this will be the local domain that we're using.
So Camille, what are some reasons for why we would want to join the domain?
Well, for one, joining the domain ensures all computers are in the same network. And this will allow us to use Active Directory credentials for security into our Pi system, which can be done through a mapping. So you'll see this later in the video. So in order for these changes to take place, we'll need to restart the computer. There's one more thing that we also want to do that will require a restart. So we're going to go to the top under Devices. We're going to first remove the disk from the virtual drive. Now this was the for the Windows Server 2008 R2. Then also under the Devices tabs, we're going to install guest add-ins. Once we've selected that, we can go to Computer and run the VirtualBox guest add-ins additions. So you may be wondering why we're going through this process, and this is so we can easily share the YouTube video folder that we presented earlier. Install. But we will also need to always trust the software from the Oracle Corporation, so make sure that that box is checked. So now we're going to do the reboot. And one thing to note is when you're working in this virtual machine environment with VirtualBox, you'll need to do a write control and delete to log in. So now that we're logged in, we can see that we successfully changed the computer name and joined the domain. Our next step is going about doing some final configuration so that we can access that shared folder. We're going to do this through the command prompt. And in order to know what we need to type, we can easily reference the VirtualBox under Settings, Shared Folders. So as you can see at the bottom here, it says list all shared folders accessible to this machine, and we're going to use this command to access the shared folder. So this is what we're going to type in the command prompt on our VM1. And our folder name was YouTube video. Since it did have the spaces, we're going to have to add the underscores when we're specifying the name here. So the command was completed successfully. So now if we go to computer, we can see our YouTube video folder right here, and we're able to access all the installation files. So in order to make this full screen, we need to do a write control and then F. And we can switch this. So now that we have the operating system and the shared folder on this VM setup, we're going to go back to our host machine in VirtualBox and create the remaining two VMs for this process. So then now that we've finished setting up all three virtual machines, one thing that we want to do before we begin the installation is we want to check the connection between them. So let's review. We have VM1, which is the Pi server. We have VM2, which is the interface node. And our third VM, which could also be your host machine if you're following along with this activity, which is VM3, the clients. So let's start on the interface side, and we want to ping the Pi server. We're going to do this through the command prompt, and this will check the connection between them. So for this, we're going to need to know the IP address of the Pi server. So we're going to switch to the Pi server and use the command prompt ipconfig. And so we can see the address is 10.8.20.239. So we do have a reply, and it looks like our connection is successful. We're also going to do the same thing on the client side. So again, command prompt, ping, and we're going to enter the IP address of the Pi server node. And we have another successful connection. So at this point, we have our VM set up and we're ready to begin the installation process.